As the rest replaced the fallen Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanyahitsa, the opposition in Parliament has united and assembled two candidates for Speaker and Deputy Speaker positions after primaries. Asman Basalirwa, the Bujiri Municipality MP of Jema, defeated UPC's Jonathan Odu of Erute South to carry the opposition flag, whereas Chiyoga County MP Moses Okot Jr. Bitek of FDC went through unopposed to carry the opposition ticket in the race for the Deputy Speaker.
Asman, who has garnered the highest number of votes, is hereby declared the flag bearer for opposition of the 11th Parliament.
There is no any leader that is bigger than other leaders, neither am I bigger than the caucus. So we have amicably resolved to back up Honorable Okot Bitek to take on our flag as opposition. And I know he's the best striker for tomorrow's race.
We are very confident, depending on the candidates we have selected and their credentials to be speakers.
The speakership position fell vacant upon death of the Speaker Jacob Olanya, whereas the Deputy Speaker position is getting vacant as soon as the Deputy Speaker ascends to the top seat. The two opposition candidates vowed to give NRM a bloody nose in the polls slated for tomorrow at Kololo.
Must retain the integrity of this house. Professor Evi Daise, a renowned constitutional lawyer, did say Parliament can make and unmake anything. That should be our position. We must not be considered to be second citizens. Neither should we be a second arm of government. We must always remain the top arm of government.
Mathias Mpoga, the leader of opposition, called for unity in the speakership race to avoid repeating the embarrassing history of last year when the opposition candidate in the speakership race, Ibrahim Semuju, polled only 15 votes.
We come here to make our presence not just seen, but known and understood. And for the work of today and the output of tomorrow, the world will understand that we mean what we say and we act on what we actually say.
Meanwhile, opposition leadership in Parliament has also paid tribute to the Speaker Jacob Olanya by signing in the condolence book. Mpoga expressed grief over Olanya's fundamental pledges that he didn't get a chance to fulfill in his leadership that was cut short by death.
As Parliament, in a way, we lost a leader who had made a lot of promise at the beginning of Parliament. Particularly, he made a promise that this Parliament will be different from the rest. And therefore, we had lived in hope that the leader of this institution will guide us into a direction that will engender fresh hope and give reason for Ugandans to believe in the power of Parliament in guiding and changing their fortunes. Unfortunately, God's ways are not our ways. We thank our brother for that he did as a leader. He's been young, but has done a lot over the years. Therefore, we thank God for what he did. For that he did not do by omission or commission, we pray that God finds in his fortitude reason to forgive him and grant him eternal rest.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.